I'm back here with my friend Silver, my middle school friend from middle school. Did track and field together.
We're still cool. Still pals, bro.
Remember when you passed out on the track?
Let's not talk about that. Because he has a misconstrued idea of what happened.
That kid, remember what kid beat you?
I'm not going to play these games.
That fake pass out. Anyway, do you know Bohemian Rhapsody?
No.
Have you ever heard of it?
No.
Well, today is the last day you've never heard of it.
Okay, let's get it.
Let's jump right into it.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide. No escape from reality.
Just to give you some information, this was a 1975
song.
It's a long time ago, way before we were here. This is what music was like in that time. All right.
Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. I'm just a poor boy. I need no sympathy. Because I'm easy come, easy go. Little high, little low. Anyway, the wind blows doesn't really matter to me. To me.
How old were they? They sound like a bunch of kids.
I'm not sure what their ages were, but I'm sure they were probably in their like mid-20s or something.
Not that I have an issue with their voice. It's just like very youthful.
Yeah, youthful. Dude, this guy can sing his ass off.
The soprano one? The one that with the high-pitched voice?
Whatever you want to call it. I don't know the notes. Whichever one you're referring to, I'm sure we all agree with it. Using these big words on me.
Mama just killed a man. Put a gun against his head. Pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Just begun, but now I've gone and thrown it all away. Mama, ooh, didn't mean to make you cry. If I'm not back again this time tomorrow, carry on, carry on. Is it nothing really matters?
Anything yet?
Sometimes I wish I knew how to sing.
Yeah, that's one. Like, I've been singing this song like so much, and I know I sound like shit, but it's so captivating, dude. The silkiness of his voice. And then you pair that with the lyrics. Mama, I just killed the man. I put a gun up against his head. I pulled the trigger. Now he's dead. It's a metaphor.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, basically technically what we did, right, in a way where you put a gun against your old self because you noticed some things and you're like, you know what,
time to kill,
the old me or whoever people saw me as. This is myself. You know, when you're growing into, like, your adult body, but, like, just to personalize it, not, maybe this is not what he meant, but you know what I mean? You can internalize these songs and make it personal to you. That's what I like about it. And super silky smooth. Everyone in the band can sing. The guy on the guitar, he can sing. He's freaking crazy.
Nothing really matters. Too late. My time has come. Sent shivers down. Oh,
Any opinions on it so far?
I'm loving the guitar, man.
Dude, that thing is like, I have a half chub right now. What do you have?
A half chub?
Yeah, my cooler.
This guy, dog.
I can see it. Yeah, playing, yeah, you man. Feel
Stop
it.
Playing, dog.
But this is what I like about this song. It's not like, because you know, today, not saying all the songs today are like this, but the substance and the music, a lot of the mainstream things that are out today. What are you hearing? It's either drugs, it's either money, it's either or clothes, sex, yeah. sex, which is fine, right? But when is the majority of the music that's coming out?
Yeah, what's different?
How many little kids do you hear singing wet ass P word? And that's who they're record labels are pushing that shit like crazy.
It's unfortunate.
It's extremely.
They don't make music as they like how they did back then.
No, it's not. Nothing's.
It's not balanced.
Nah, yeah.
Like,
it is.
I'm not saying that you shouldn't, like, you can't make those type of music. Yeah, go ahead and do your thing. But when it's the majority, as you said, when it's the bulk of the.
Yeah, what's out? What's going
what's
on?
What's out? It's like.
And it's so cringy. It's like.
It's cringy.
Listen, because our generation, this music has been our entire generation, right? The stuff that's out now. So when you're 10, you hear it. Cool. 15, you hear it. Cool. 20, you hear it. Cool. 25, you're like, bro, when are you guys going to grow up?
Exactly.
You have like 30, 40-year-old adults singing songs by 20, 19-year-old kids mm-hmm. talking about murder, 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 murder.
Murder, 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 murder.
I heard a song called, we probably got to check that out, called Murder, Murder, Murder,
yeah,
Murder,
I heard
Murder.
That song. that song go hard.
It may go hard. But it's like I was like, bro, okay. You know what? Let me stop before I start raging.
But what's different, like as you said earlier, in regard to like the generation, like compared to this generation to our generation,
mm-hmm.
we can look back to the songs that we enjoy. Like we could go back to the sex songs, we could go back to the money songs, we could go back to the drug songs, but we also could go back to the romantic. Type of life story type of songs where it's like, damn, like they made real music.
Yeah, but that's like lyrics. That's like us taking because we weren't around at this time.
Yeah.
So the music of our time was not this. This was way before us.
But I'm like talking about like songs like Mary J. Blige or like, you know, songs like the love songs where.
You mean the R&B stuff?
The R&B stuff.
I mean, it's I can't even recall the last time I actually went.
Oh, be like, without you, baby.
You know, like Boyz II Men, or maybe Genuine, or
Genuine.
Yeah, those guys are pretty cool.
Yeah.
Will you do the fandango? Thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo,
Magnifico.
Oh, oh, I'm just a poor boy, nobody loves me.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, sparing his life from this monstrosity.
Easy come, easy go, will you let me go?
Bismillah,
no, we will not let you go.
Let him go.
Dude,
that was nice.
That entire sequence.
There, that was nice.
Like, have you realized we've listened to like 3 songs already in this one?
In this one day.
Not this one day. This one song.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
Because remember at the beginning, Mama just killed mm-hmm. the man, and then it went to a different tone, and now we're here. It's like giving me, you know, you didn't even realize it. The transitions have happened already.
It reminds me like a
a concert,
like a concert band. Like, where they're playing all type of, like, different instruments where it's, like, just straight to your, like, it screams right at you.
Mm-hmm.
But in a nice way. Hey, mama.
What?
I try to replicate what they said, bro.
Oh, you're saying, oh, mama mia, let me go. But you say it again?
No, never mind.
Never
let me go.
Mamma mia,
mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub has a devil put aside for me, for me, for me.
That transition, when I heard it, like after, you know, the initial reaction, just vibing to it, it's like, you think it's done, but it keeps going. It's just so seamless, dude. What are you supposed to do?
Just listen.
And you notice how it's the instruments playing, and then it transitions to him saying, ooh. But it's like, he sounds like the instrument almost. All the instrument sounds like him. Whichever one you want to take. His voice is an instrument, dude.
But did it go back to the first singer?
No, it went back to Freddie, the main singer, the guy that's singing the most song. But you just got to like, listen, this time, listen for the transition. And when you hear the voice come in, you'll see what I mean about how it blends in like so seamlessly perfect. Humans shouldn't be able to do that.
I like the ending.
Okay, Queen, Bohemian Rhapsody, your first time reacting or listening to it. What are your thoughts?
Made me think about, as the lyrics suggested, his past, like how he's apologetic about his past, so to speak. Because I heard him saying like an apology to his mom.
Yeah, you know, like a metaphor.
Yeah, like metaphor.
When your mom is like, you're not my son. What happened? You know, that's when he said, I put a gun against his head, triggering out. That's how I interpreted it, right? Like, he's changing. He's someone else now.
It just made me think about how, you know, how I was raised and how things were a little bit chaotic growing up. And then things started to smooth down.
Mm-hmm.
As life progressed, as I've started to think differently, consider other things, you know, and...
Think differently.
Yeah, think differently.
That's a big part, right?
Yeah.
Think differently. I would have never been listening to this. Had it not have been for the people who suggested it, and on a whim, I just was like, I'll give other things a chance. Then this came up. It's like you said, growing up, things change. And like a song like this, like... I wouldn't have a problem with my child listening to this song.
Yeah.
I don't have to be worried. I don't have to, you know, how they sell to the kids and they're just speaking about sex and stuff like that, which, like we said, it has its purpose, but when it's just overly saturated in the market, it gets kind of annoying. But Like, you know, we're in our 20s. This music was long before we existed, but it's still present. It's still prevalent today.
Yeah.
So words spoken by these guys in the past will still live on because you just can't recreate something like this, in my opinion. Until it happens, I don't know if it'll happen. But just another note, he died. Freddie Mercury, the main dude. Yeah.
Wait, the other artists are still alive?
I think so, yeah. So, yeah, so we won't ever get to hear him perform again.
That's crazy. He had such a beautiful voice.
Yeah, freaking one of the, wonderful. From what I've learned, one of the golden voices of that time or of ever. And apparently he has an opera? I have to check that out, but he does opera.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure he does. He has the voice of an opera.
What do you think about his dress code?
It reminds me of, I don't know whether or not if you're familiar with this anime. I'm an anime fan, by the way.
Yeah, we know.
It's called JoJo Adventure.
I've heard about it. I haven't watched it
yet. You have to watch it. Given your personality, given
but the fact... he's kind of dressed like... Doesn't One Punch Man wear something like this? With the cape and the onesie?
With the tightness? Yeah, with the onesie. In terms of the onesies, yeah. But... The way that they move, it more tailors towards JoJo Adventures.
I have to check that out.
Check it out, bro.
Yeah, hilarious. But this is like stage attire. It's not like they just walked around like that. This is just for performance purposes.
I don't know. For some reason, as I was watching the video, I kept on thinking about JoJo Adventure.
Mm. So, verdict on the song?
Pass. As in
you like it.
Okay, I like it. Okay.
Not pass as in this was garbage. Okay. Turn it off. Blow it up.
Okay. Thumbs up.
So introducing my friend here to Queen. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know there wasn't like a lot of commentary, but he's not used to being on camera, so forgive him.
I'm usually not shy.
He's usually not shy when he's recording himself, but when he's being recorded by someone else, he kind of clamps his butt cheeks in a little bit, but you know we'll loosen.
Bro, my cheeks are
We're gonna loosen those. All right, people are gonna think we're smashing.
Who cares? I mean, it's 2022.
I smash who I want.
Yeah, man, and I don't blame you. I've been working. Let me stop.
Yeah, let's stop.